Welcome back to the Hot Shot Radio Show. This is your boy Hot Shot. We back with another flick. You already know how we do. If you're new to the channel, please hit that like, share, and subscribe button. Show your boy that free love. Don't be shy. You dig? We about to break down Nicki Minaj's lyrics on the PoloG track titled For the Love of New York.
All right, y'all. In this track, we got PoloG, where he's singing slash rapping about a girl that has suffered because of his wrongdoings, and he's trying to make up for it.
And we got Nicki on the track, of course. You already know Nicki be choking that shit. I mean, Nicki begins her verse with saying that her man made her cry and he led her to her demise.
Let's go ahead and listen.
First part of Nicki verse, she talking about, I should have never gave it to you in the first place, and why the fuck I moved in with you in that first place.
Nicki goes on to saying, I was the first one to put you on to her Mayez, which is the maker of Birkin bag. Now you know she gotta be talking about some bum dude. I mean, she can't be talking about a rich celebrity rapper dude, cause they got money, they know what Hermes, they know what exotic beaches look like. I mean, so
in my opinion, she talking about somebody from the hood that hasn't seen much of the world. You dig what I'm saying? Like, you follow where I'm coming from. Let's continue listening.
Could take your surname, kept you from them bird brains. Now you in my burn book, fuck you and what's her name. I'd rather physical, emotional's the worst pain. You triggering my anxiety in the worst way.
On this next part of Nicki verse, she says, could have took your surname, kept you from them bird brains. Now you in my burn book, fuck you and what's her name. I'd rather physical, emotion is the worst pain. You triggering my anxiety in the worst way. So I wonder who she talking to over here. Like, if she's talking to Kenneth Petty, I mean, she could be talking about his ex rep on Noe. But who knows if she's talking about or referring to Jennifer. Let's continue listening.
Sometimes the best thing you could do is step away. I'll always be the one that you let get away. Put on our favorite song and I just let it play. Pull out the kid out and I might just let it spray.
Yo, your girl Nicki goes on to saying sometimes the best thing you can do is step away.
She says I'll always be the one you let get away. Put on our favorite song and I just let it play. Pull out and get at it, and I might just let it spray. Like, she talking about shooting shit up. So Nicki on some real grimy, greasy street shit right now. She on her gutter shit.
She ain't taking no shit from Kenneth or nobody else. Allegedly. Now let's listen to the last part of Nicki's verse on this track.
I'll be...
So at the end of her last verse, Nicki says that she'll be gone, and she'll tell her bitch to pick her up in the morning, and don't act like this is normal. She goes, this is toxic, don't act like it's normal. So she reminds herself that this is a toxic relationship, a toxic situation,
and she's had enough.
Nicki is known for vocalizing her happiness when it comes to her past relationship with Meek Mill on her featured tracks like All Eyes on Me and By Your Heart. Nicki also made great music during the time frame of her relationship with Safari. Nicki clearly seemed happy throughout most of her relationship with Safari, which resulted in some of her best tracks. Something I've noticed about Nicki's current relationship with Kenneth is that she hasn't made any music really expressing her happiness with him. Another thing is that the music she has put out since being with Kenneth hasn't been as good as the
music she had put out before him.
Do y'all feel Nicki is capable of humiliating and embarrassing herself by speaking of her past relationships, knowing these men have moved on?
Keep in mind, Nicki Minaj tweeted her favorite lines from both hers and Polo G's verses.
Will her relationship be lasting?
Or is
Kenneth's legal troubles taking a toll on Nicki? Please let me know in the comments below what you think, and I'll catch you guys on the next flick. Peace.